Hello everyone, how are you doing? This is MD Tech here with another quick tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to download and install Dell drivers for your printer software on your computer or laptop. So this should be a fairly quick tutorial and we're going to jump right into it. And we're going to start by opening up a web browser. It doesn't matter which one, but you want to navigate over to google.com. And now into Google, you want to type in Dell printer drivers. And you want to begin searching that up. And besides the ones that might be listed as ads up here, I recommend not selecting an ad. And you want to go directly to a Dell domain here. We can see this is www.dell.com. We're going to select that page. I would not recommend going to any third-party websites that are trying to get you to click on some advertisements or something along those lines. So if you want to select view products down here, I recommend you do that. And then select the printers button. And now you have a few options. So if you just have a laser printer, you want to select one of the first ones up here. If you have an inkjet printer, you can select that one. And you can also select printing solutions, which will be the last one here. So let's say I have an all-in-one inkjet printer here. So if you have a product name, you'd want to just type it in right here. So just type in, like, for example, 928. It says Dell 928 all-in-one inkjet printer. Click on that. And now I'd also even recommend, if you do not find your printer through that method, go back to Google and just type in your printer name and you'll likely be redirected to a Dell domain and you'll see a page that looks like this, but maybe it will be a little bit easier than going through what I just showed. But I'm just going to put that out there if what I just showed you guys did not yield the printer. And keep in mind, the printer name here should be clearly labeled somewhere on your printer, especially if it's a new printer. It should definitely have it all over the box. And there will likely be stickers over your printer itself that should have the name of the printer. So I just want to put that out there. So at this point, you would enter in the operating system you want to install this for. So we can see that it's only giving us Windows 7 and older, even though it should still be able to work for our newer Windows 10 computer. And you're going to get that with older and newer printers. You're going to get a little bit of compatibility issues, perhaps. But there's really nothing you can do about that, and it will still apply for this tutorial. So once you've done that, underneath category, select printers. And you can see there's only one option already down here, so there's really no point in narrowing it down even further. So I'm just going to select the one download down here, and we can see it's this all-in-one printer. And I'm going to select this little download icon right here. And again, this should be very similar depending on what printer you're using. The process will be slightly different, but the general concept is the same. They just have so many different printers, all of these big companies, I really can't go through every individual printer. Okay, so the download itself is about 86 megabytes, so it's definitely kind of big, but depending on the printer, it might be a little bit smaller or larger. So you just want to be patient, this will take a moment. And once it's finished downloading, I'm just going to left click on the button or the executable one time to run it. Select yes. And then just select on OK. I'd recommend just keeping it in the default folder to unzip it, and then unzip. Should say it was unzipped successfully, and just be patient here. And it's going to say welcome to the Dell program, and you can tell this is probably a little bit of an older printer here, but we're still going to select next, and then yes. It's going to ask if you want to install the default components. I'm going to keep both of them selected here, and then select next. Okay, so at the end it should say it has been successfully installed. Press the finish button to exit the installation and to connect the USB cable. Click on the finish button right here. And that should pretty much be about it, guys. I would recommend restarting your computer after it's done. And if you are using what appears to be a newer printer, you will likely have options to install a wireless or wired connection. I recommend that you just follow suit with whatever you are planning on using the printer for. And it should be a pretty straightforward tutorial from there. So I do hope this brief video was able to help you guys out. And as always, thank you for watching. And I look forward to catching you all in the next tutorial. Goodbye.